Coming up, we are going to be talking about how businesses are reopening, but there are some businesses in particular where it's a little harder to reopen and make sure that you're still protecting customers when it comes to stopping the spread of COVID-19, including hair salons, nail spas. We're going to be talking to Jeff Alford. He's the president and CEO of Cosmetic Brands of North America with some advice on how to go about this. Stay with us. As some businesses start to reopen their doors this week, some businesses like hair and nail salons have a lot more to consider when it comes to keeping customers safe from COVID-19 and a potential future outbreak. Joining us to tell us more about their pre-opening and post-opening protocol handbooks and advice is Jeff Alford from the Cosmetic Brands of North America. Jeff, thank you so much for joining us. And for people who are not familiar, right off the top, can you just tell us what Cbond Group does?
For over 10 years now, Pooja, the Cbond Group has been educating the beauty industry, initially in Canada and now into the United States, on the entire protocols of infection control and the need for strict infection control procedures. So we've been doing that and supplying the products, the liquids, disinfectants, sterilants, to the industry.
Well, your advice couldn't be more prevalent than it is right now going through this pandemic. So what is the advice to salon spa owners and their staff when it comes to protocols that should be in place?
The main advice we're giving the salon owners and their staff is it's time to get really in-depth education now. It's time to learn protocols at every level. Up until now, many parts of our industry have felt that it really wasn't critical. For example, the hair industry has felt that they were not really a critical service from an infection control perspective. But now all that has changed, and we're letting all of them, all the staff and salon owners and the individual practitioners who work out of their homes or mobile, to make sure they get the education and understand the protocols properly.
Now, when it comes to a customer, so if I was to go into one of these salons, what should I expect in terms of the screening measures that will be in place? There's also a lot involved. There's robes and equipment and a lot more that you're sort of touching in surfaces.
Yes, it's very important now in this new normal for the public also to be educated as to what they should expect when they go. For example, everything from when you make your appointment to whether you can even enter or whether you have to sit in the car, everything from the moment you walk in the door to when you leave the door and everything in between will now have protocols, will have procedures. And it's a very confusing time. It's a very difficult time, both for the public and for the professionals. So we're encouraging the public to communicate, to ask, to talk about it. We're encouraging the professionals to talk about it, to communicate to the public, so that everybody understands what are the proper protocols and why it's being done.
Would you recommend to customers that, you know, they continue to wear masks and gloves when entering any of these salons?
Absolutely. I mean, social distancing will obviously be a new normal in the salons. Some salons will allow you to wear your own masks. Others will regulate that you will have to wear their mask. There'll be sanitizers the moment you enter and before you leave. Sanitizing of your hands. All the staff should have their faces covered. In certain areas, sneeze shields need to be up, for example, on manicure tables. So there will be a lot of little details, and the public and the salons now need to educate themselves and go to resources where they can learn what all these procedures are and not be surprised or be shocked when they walk in, for example, and have their temperature taken.
And what about when it comes to bringing your children to appointments or even seniors who need spa and salon services?
Well, a number of salons are making senior hours at the beginning of the day, for example, and making that especially for the seniors. Every salon needs to ask themselves, what are the proper protocols? Generally, many salons are saying, no, we don't want children brought in. If they are not the customer, then no children are allowed, and that's quite appropriate. But these are all the new the new protocols that everyone needs to A, talk about, and B, communicate very clearly. For example, salons might now charge an extra $2 or $5 for all that cost of all the extra materials they have to buy. So there needs to be a tremendous amount of communication and understanding between the public and the salon world.
Yeah, and even as we're watching visuals right now, blow drying, I understand, is a problem. Can you explain why?
Well, a blow dryer will tend to circulate any droplets in the air. So obviously, and blow dryers could circulate any germs that might even have accumulated in the blow dryer. So it's some salons, for example, are making blow dry rooms where people are going in there to get their blow drying done. Because the concern of a blow dryer is that if someone sneezes or coughs and there are droplets in the air, the blow dryer is now spreading the droplets.
Yeah, well, I mean, you've outlined just some of the things to consider when reopening, and there is a lot, and we want to make sure everybody is doing it correctly. So we appreciate your advice, and we also want to encourage, Jeff, everybody to go to infectioncontroleducation.com, and that's where they can actually see the manual and some of the recommendations by CBON.
Absolutely. That website, infectioncontroleducation.com, has specifically been set up for all the professionals to go get their protocols, for the public to go and see what the protocols are, so that everyone can communicate with each other and understand what the new normal will be.
Jeff, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your time, and stay safe.
Thank you so much, Pooja.
Thank you.